Welcome back to Animal Crossing New Horizons. I'm Dear Darling, I shall see what's going on the island of Fawn Hollow today. Back on, apparently, another rainy day here in Fawn Hollow. It's crazy how we've gone from about one day of rain within 2 months to having rain about 50% of the time in the last 2 weeks or so. But, you know, rainy day. If it's UK weather that I'm very used to. And I do love a rain anyway, so anyway. Hello there, everyone. Right now in Fawn Hollow, it's 4:22 p.m. on Sunday, June 21st, 2020. Nothing to speak of today, but... I forgot that yesterday was cut off to enter that contest with a great prize. Oh dear. I don't think I've ever entered a contest, like one of those mailing contests. Also, this volume seems a bit low, I'll turn up a bit. Any of those mailing contests or like... things where you can have a chance of getting a small prize. Oh, I actually completely forgot I changed my style. I was like, who is this? Someone from Vivian? Good grief, Somersault. I was about to catch a most exquisite bug, but it eluded me at the very last second. I know I shouldn't give up, but I'm terribly frustrated. Thank you for letting me vent, darling. You're the best. Off to try again, Vivian. Wait, off to try again from Vivian. You know, that's just good life advice, Vivian. Whoa. Wow, we're in awe of your score above 150,000 points. At this point, you should probably be rating us. Please accept this gift and a hearty congratulations. There we go, we finally did it. We reached 150,000 and we've got our very special... da-da-da-da-da-da! Golden HHA trophy. Excuse me. I didn't play last night, I don't think. Did I play last night? I probably didn't. But it's okay, because today we're going to do something which we haven't done for a while, is we're going to go Nook Mile Island hopping, because... unfortunately, we said yesterday we said goodbye to our dear friend Eric, who has been in Fawn Hollow for quite a while now, isn't it? Hasn't he? I don't even know where to put this. I'm going to just put this directly onto this seat, I guess. There we go. It counts as a lucky item, so that's why I put it down. So yes, unfortunately, we said goodbye to Eric yesterday in Fawn Hollow. He left Fawn Hollow, and right now we have a vacant lot. Which, I suppose, will take the time to try and... what am I doing? Why am I putting that away? I might need that on the island in case I run out of things. But we're going to take the time now to go looking, basically, for someone else to fill in that Eric-sized hole in everyone's hearts. So we're going to go Nook Mile Island hopping, which we haven't done for a spectacularly long time, to be honest. So I'm going to drop off anything excess here. We're going to drop off this. We know we don't have any guests to look around for because today is a Sunday. So we only had Daisy May. Apparently have a new bulletin board. Upcoming bug off. Is everyone excited for the bug off? Mark Saturday, June 27th. That's next week on your calendars for the event. Hope to see you all. Well, we've got the first bug off coming. We need to actually go get some Nook Mile tickets. I forgot how this worked. We got the first bug off coming, and I've said my piece about the fishing tournament in New Horizons. I think it's a bit much and way too grindy and not that fun, but if they let points accumulate between every consecutive like fishing tournament, or in this case bug off, then it's not actually too bad. It's just, you know, actually doing it is a real pain. So 2,000 miles for a ticket. We could print out a lot of the time. I'm gonna print out maybe, I don't know, I'll print out 5, I guess. No, I'll print out 2, just for now. I need to also get up that guide that tells me what type of islands we have. Nook Mile Ticket Islands. Of course, now we're in summer, we have a chance of getting the Shark Island, which would be incredibly helpful for us, for getting sharks. It's past 4 p.m, so sharks are spawning. Sorry, that was quite loud. I just slammed my own thing. Let me find it. Mystery Island Data Mine. There we go. Bring up that image there. And, oh, redeem some more Nook Mile missions, apparently. We're just redeeming Nook Mile, so there we go. Spectacular work, team. We did it. And we're going to get off this rainy island and hopefully go somewhere slightly less rainy. We'll see. Not entirely sure. What other interesting islands? Because we're not really short of money anymore, so we don't really need to go harvesting fruit or anything like that. So I guess we just... we just walk on and see what villager we have, and then if it's not one we would want to invite to our island, or leave, as the case may be. I know that sounds unnecessarily harsh, but that's just how it works sometimes, unfortunately, so... Yes, we'll be heading off. As for villages I do want, I think I've spoken about this ad nauseum. I would love to have Biscuit as a lazy villager, and a smug villager, I'm not too fussy. There's quite a lot of them I'd take. So I'll sort of do it on a case-by-case basis while I see them, because I don't have a favourite smug villager. A lot of them I think are pretty cool. We'll see what island this is. There's Kid Cat. He's a jock. We don't need another jock, unfortunately, but nice to see you, Kid Cat. Are you here for survivor training too? My name's Kid Cat. What's yours? Deer, huh? And from Thorn Hollow? Alright, it's cool to meet you. Well, I'm gonna go back to surviving. Let me know if you need help lifting a tree or something. Psst. Kid Cat is adorable. I've had the option to get him before, but I turned him down because I was like... really had a jock villager and I wasn't looking for a jock villager at the time. I don't know where we're even running. I guess we could get furniture. Or we could just leave, to be honest. We could have a look around and see if we've got fossils actually buried here. That's probably a good idea to do. Fossils and furniture hunting. This one is clearly the alternate fruit island, though. The sister fruit island, so there's nothing for us to harvest here, I believe. I'm just checking the layout of the pattern, the lay of the land, and seeing if it's correct. Yeah, so we'll just leave this. And we'll return back to Thorn Hollow and fly immediately again. It's going to be a lot of flying in this episode, but I feel like it's cool. It's a good change of pace. Did I not fly? I'm ready to go home. Be very positive. Yep, let's take our leave. So, of course, even though we've returned from the airport, we're just going to go immediately again. We're going to be like Orville, or is it Wilbur? Wait, I can't remember which way around you are. I think it's Wilbur who flies, yeah. Wilbur who flies. You just start up the plane again. We're going to go to another Nook Mile Island ticket. We're going to actually burn through, not all, but we're going to burn through a decent amount of our 80,000 Nook Mile points that we've saved up for this very occasion. So yeah, Biscuit for lazy. And I don't mind for smug. Those are our two missing villager personality types. Would I take in a jock villager? I don't think there's any other jock villagers which are my favourites, so probably not. Cranky? I would take an Apollo, if I saw Apollo, probably. Apollo's pretty great. Normal villagers? Fauna, obviously. I talked about Fauna ad nauseum. I mean, she's a deer and an absolute darling. Why wouldn't I have her? Who else is there? Snoop? Ah, you are... Ah, I know your name. Like Leo or something? Ah, Bud, that's it. Hey there, awesome to meet you. My name's Bud. What about you? Where are you from? Strong standing place, another jock villager. Unfortunately, we're not in quite in the position to take another jock villager on our island right now. We have two already. And, you know, too many jocks spoil the broth. But we're ready to go home. Would I take in a Snooty villager? I think I've also spoken about this before. Snooty is my favourite type, and most of my favourite villagers are Snooty, so it would be tough. It would have I would have to really think about it, because I already love Vivian and Diana so much already. So having three Snooty villagers, I would be okay maybe with having three Snooty villagers. It would probably mean that I would allow a Snooty villager to leave at some point though. Right, what Snooty villagers would like? Freya or Whitney? Probably one of the two wolves. I might. If Becky, maybe, I'm not sure. Becky I have nostalgia for, because she was in my New Leaf town. But yeah, Sisterly Villagers, Phoebe is my favourite. There's quite a lot of good, really nice, well, I mean, all the Sisterly Villagers are quite nice, but nice designs for the Sisterly Villagers. Not many I have too much nostalgia for, apart from Phoebe, so. That was a really weird noise, I don't know what just happened over there, but... I don't know if you heard that, it was like rawr, rawr. I think it might be a kid outside actually. Maybe one of my neighbour's kids or something. I can't see them from my seat and I'm not going to go stare at them out the window. It's a little bit unnerving, I'd imagine. What's the other villager type? Peppy villagers. Would I have taken another Peppy villager? Maybe. I'm trying to think through what Peppy villagers I have I really like. Peppy villagers, I've got to be honest, especially in the past, they weren't my favourite personality. Not that I dislike them or anything, they're just more like, out of the female personalities, they're probably my least favourite, I'm sorry to say. Not because I dislike them, but because I just like the other personalities so much more. They definitely have grown on me, though, in this version. Or maybe I've changed as a person. I don't know, it's hard to tell. I quite like all the villager types. Especially Snooty. Oh my god, I love how dapper Roscoe looks. It's so good. But yeah, we'll just keep on searching. We'll see who turns up. We might see some of your favourite villagers. Or we might not. I'm sorry if I turned down your favourite villager. But we all know everyone's got different favourite villagers. We all have different nostalgia and experiences. And, you know, preferences for designs and that sort of thing. So it shouldn't be perhaps too surprising that the villagers I would like to have in my island might be different to yours in the end. If that isn't evident enough by how popular Eric is. I think, like, Welcome Eric was, like, my second most popular... Maybe first most popular. No, I think Welcome Vivian is, I can't remember. Video on my channel, I don't even know. It's, like, nearly at 1,000 views, just randomly. But, I'm not complaining. It's nice to see how many people love their favourite villagers, so hopefully I can get a good rotation of villagers going and we can, have fun. Talking about all your favourite experiences of your favourite villagers. Let's see who we got up here. I have never seen you before. Ozzy. Oh hey, nice to meet you. I'm Ozzy. Cool, so you're a deer from Born Hollow? Man, that's real cool. Let's have some fun. Well, we're here together, old bear. I assume you're a lazy villager. You have a very interesting design, but unfortunately, Ozzy, you're not quite who we're looking for. This sounds like more like an audition process rather than like a friend befriending process, but it actually is. I don't mean to make it seem so like judgmental and treat all the villagers so harshly, but unfortunately, because of the way Animal Crossing is designed, we can only have a limited amount of villagers. If we could have, as I say this every time, more villagers on our islands, I would love to invite so many villagers, even ones that I've never even met before, like Ozzy over there. Unfortunately, we can't. That is my dream, though. My dream Animal Crossing game is a bustling metropolis where we look after like a big city with like apartments and all that, and invite tons and tons of villagers around, and we just spend the time just talking to villagers all that, all that sort of thing. Unfortunately, that's never going to happen because that's ridiculous. We'll never have like 100 villagers in one game. Kind of defeats the purpose of having varied islands, but that's my dream. I know it's never going to happen, but that is my dream. Oh, I thought that was Vivian for a second, and I was like, what? How is there another Vivian here? I didn't quite see who that was, though. You are also someone I've never seen before. Also, what island is this? I don't recognise this one. Curly Island. It's apparently Dragonfly Island? I don't know what that even means, but hello. Tybalt? Another Jock villager. Would you all say the same thing, to be honest? I believe this one is really good for catching water bugs. A giant water bugs. Well, but we've got diving beetles now, which makes it a little bit harder, but still. Bell Bottom Dubstep. So we'll leave. Wow, it's pretty windy out there. In real life, not in Animal Crossing. Don't think it's very windy in Animal Crossing right now. I'm just watching the trees sway. How many more Nook Miles tickets do we have? We got one more. And we are about halfway through. So we're actually really quick, seeing as we don't care about money anymore in Animal Crossing, but we can be really quick in going through all these islands. I suppose we can take this time to talk about the black market side of Animal Crossing. It's weird about Animal Crossing, such a wholesome, casual game, has such an intensive black market based off the villagers and favourites and all that sort of thing. Like, it's absolutely insane. If you see people are like trading Animal Crossing villagers like crazy, not like crazy, but for like absurd amounts, like especially people like Raymond. I know everyone knows about Raymond now because he's so insanely popular, going for like 2,000 Nook Miles tickets or something. I don't know what island this is. I don't know who you are. I don't think I recognize you. Oh my word, Chester. Ah, there's someone on this island. Oh, you're here visiting too? Hey, I'm Chester. Your deer from Born Hollow? Neat. Didn't expect to make a friend here. This island's so cool, rookie. Ah, oh, you seem like a lazy villager. You're very cute, unfortunately. I forgot your name already. Chester, right? You're not what we're looking for. Oh, what island is this? This is one of the standard islands, I'm pretty sure. So I'm not too interested in that. Oh, my phone's not even plugged in. I was just looking at my phone for a second, I thought I heard a notification, I didn't. My phone's low on battery though. I should plug it in, but it makes such an annoying noise when I'm recording. And I've been recording earlier today, I was recording some bug fables just earlier. If you want to know which episode it was the recipe, the cooking episode, so that took freaking forever, to be honest. Sorry, excuse my language, that took a large amount of time, shall we say. And I'll be recording more bug fables later. I'm having so much time now, actually, I feel like I'm almost stretching out the amount of bug fables, episodes I'm doing because of just how much I'm enjoying it. Like, I'm actually going to 100% this entire game because I'm having so much fun playing it. Which I didn't think I would do initially when I started playing it, but you know, it's just that much fun. Highly recommended it. Recommend it if you're a fan of RPGs. It's probably been my favourite game I've played on this channel so far. I don't know. Animal Crossing is sort of like a different thing. Like, Bug Fables is like a big spike of how much I like it. Well, Animal Crossing is like that steady, that solid bedrock I like in my life, you know? I like to casually relax with it. But Bug Fables, it engages my brain. Animal Crossing is just sort of a medium for me to talk randomly over things. Oh, I was talking about the Animal Crossing, the Villager Black Market. So yeah, if you don't know, people use like Nook Miles tickets and bells, because people don't really need bells anymore, but they use Nook Miles tickets as a currency, because you can do what I'm doing right now, is you can search through villages by just going island hopping. Nook Miles ticket island hopping, like an incredible amount of times. And I mean, by the law of large numbers, which says if you visit basically enough islands, you'll eventually find the village you want. So technically, any villager can be bought with some amount of tickets. But of course, you know, some villages have much more popular designs or a much wider appeal to the general audiences, like Raymond, Marshall, Audi, people like that. Well, animals like that, I should say. So they, of course, sell for quite a lot of Nook Miles tickets. I mean, that's just how certain people play it. The only reason I find it weird, I think, is because that's not how I play, to be honest. That's sort of like min-maxing style. That sort of thing. I sort of play just, you know, casually to relax and that everything. But what relaxing is to each person is different, and in that case, a lot of people want to get their perfect villagers straight off the bat of that sort of thing, so, you know, I don't blame them for grinding out the Nook Miles tickets and then, you know, training them online to get their guaranteed villager, that sort of thing. But the most hilarious thing happened is because of that black market, there was one person who was a hacker, and he really didn't like the fact that there was a black market in Animal Crossing. You know what he did? He hacked in a load of villages and just gave them away for free to absolutely super undercut the entire market. So what he did is, like, I think he just hacked in Raymond over and over again and just went on Twitter and was like, I'm giving out Raymond for free, message me or something if you want it. So I don't know if that's actually affected the market value of Raymond. So it's so weird talking about villages with market values and things like that. It feels like a certain trade, which I won't mention, but which is not very hopeful, but oh my god, fuchsia. Do I take fuchsia or not? Fuchsia is super cool and someone I have fantastic experience with before because she was on my new leaf island. I love her as a sisterly villager, but then we'll be missing both a lazy and a smug villager. You know, screw that, I'm taking fuchsia. Fuchsia, you're coming to my island. Yo, how's it going? Have we met? I'm Fuchsia. Gotta say, I had no idea what I was gonna get on this trip, but changing up the pace is its own reward, right? Anyway, this little place is so calm. Really, lets me get my head straight. Exactly what I need, Precious. Alright, that's enough out of me. You take care and I'll get back to staring at that gorgeous horizon. I feel like she should have an accent. This place is fun and all, but I don't know. I think I need to shape things up, Precious. Maybe a day on an empty-ish island is aiming too low. Maybe I need to really get away. Get away to my island. Cutting right to it, huh? You sure you want someone like me around? Also, where you're from anyway? Oh, Fallen Hollow? I think I've heard of it. Isn't it nice, sir? You know, I think a move might be exactly what I need to drag myself out of my rut. Plus, I'll have you around to introduce me to everyone and show me where the cool parties are and stuff. Oh, I'm great at stuff. Alright, you're on. Wow, I totally didn't expect to make any huge decisions all the way out here, but that's fate for you. Guess I got some paperwork to do. Who do I need to talk to about that? Tom Nook, huh? Cool, I'll bug him and get that rock rolling. Be there soon, Precious. Yay, Fuchsia. Another deer for the island. Maybe I should just get all the deers on my island. No, that's silly. But still, I'm glad we invited Fuchsia. because Fuchsia is someone I had on my new leaf. Was it a village? City? I don't know. Or whatever. And Fuchsia really grew on me there. At first, I was like, why are you literally bright Fuchsia? Your folk colouring is so bright and your design is very interesting. But then her like sassy attitude is so good. And she was very, very, very generous and kind. She gave me a lot of presents and stuff, so I have a lot of good memories of that. So of course I'm going to invite her to the island. And then for now, I guess we'll go about our daily business. I won't move flowers because I don't think we have enough time. We've only got 10 minutes. But I will try and give out some prezzies. Welcome to Nick's Cranny. Let's get some wrapping paper up in here. Oh, excuse me, my stomach is making most horrible noises. At some point, I'm going to have to rearrange and redecorate everyone's houses because Fuchsia having Eric's decorations and like Rowan having hippos and Lily having puddles doesn't really make sense, but that's a huge project and undertaking which I'm not quite ready to do quite yet, so that's something I have to do in the future and I have to think about who gets what designs. I think that's something I'll probably do when I get my final 10 villages, you know, once I've really got the 10 villages I'm wanting to stick with for the rest of my time, but for now we'll rotate in and out villages as we see fit, because you know that's what it's about, meeting tons of new villages, and we'll be able to say hello to Fuchsia tomorrow when she moves in. And I'm super excited for that. Fuchsia is great. Hopefully you all see that. I don't know how popular she is in general, but her sassy nature, she's going to obviously get along very well with Flo, I'd imagine. Them being both sisterly types, with that sort of can-do attitude. I remember when Fuchsia was on my new leaf island, she asked to leave at one point, and I accidentally said no, and I was like, no, don't leave. And my stomach. What are you doing, stomach? Stop this. Ah, I don't know why what I expected to happen there, but you know, that makes sense. How many is that now? Yeah, she wanted to leave and I accidentally said leave. And I was like, oh no, not Fuchsia. So I spam chatted with her until she said, oh okay, I guess I'll stay because you seem to want me so much. And that's how I learned. But you can convince them to stay in New Leaf. I don't think it works in New Horizons, actually, is what I've heard. Is once you say you're okay to leave, you can't convince them otherwise, maybe? I'm not, don't quote me on that, I'm not entirely certain, but anyway, we'll run around, try and find some villagers to give some stuff to. We didn't find any rare islands, or if we did, I didn't realise, and thus screwed myself out of it, but whatever. That's just how she goes sometimes. We're just going to take a visit to our villagers right now. See what they got going on. See what they want to say, you know? Have conversations. Hello, Lily. Lily, I'm here to tell you that we have a new villager coming in tomorrow. Moving in. Fuchsia, you never met her before? I'm sure you'll love her. Only 650 bells. As you do, Lily, as you do. You don't need to give me anything. I do like your glasses. Glasses seem very inconvenient for a frog to buy. Like, what do you even rest them against? Your actual eyes? How do you ever wear a hat as a frog? Do golden roses only need to be, like, you only need to water them once of a golden rose, but always produce golden roses? Or always have a chance to produce golden roses? I don't know how it works. Because I definitely didn't water those yesterday with a golden rose because it was raining yesterday, wasn't it? Hello, Rowan. You've earned yourself an ice cold sports drink. I'm not sure if I want ice cold sports drinks right now. It's not that hot today, despite the fact it's been summer. Despite the fact it's still summer and it's still, you know, in the hot season and all that, I'm surprised how not hot it was, especially like about a month ago. It was extraordinarily hot. It was absolutely scorching, but right now I'm wearing long sleeves. I'm wearing a hoodie right now and I've got the window closed and everything. The pink ones probably must have made a red rose. I didn't mean to do that. We'll just run over here to Silvana. She's busy fishing, so I don't think we'll be able to give her anything, but we'll say hello. I feel like you're staring at me, and it's making me nervous. I'm sorry, Silvana, I'll look away. My stomach is actually making most horrible noises right now, and I was planning to record more bug fables after this, so... I've been doing a lot of recording recently. Like, yesterday I recorded like 5 different videos, and I was like, whoa. I don't remember what I recorded as well. I recorded 2 short hikes and I think 2 bug fables. I'm recording more bug fables today. It's past 4 PM, so that's not going to be what we want. So yeah. I finished my drawing for... Let's check if she's moving in here, yep. For the next series, which we'll be doing after a short hike, which will be Rakuen by Laura Shigihara. I'm still working on the snake bird one. The snake bird... drawing should be pretty easy, but that'll be replacing bug fables when we eventually get to the end of it. We currently got enough videos, I think, till for next week, even, so. I've got a good backlog of stuff, of videos, so like I could stop recording for like 4 days and I'd be fine. 5 days, maybe? Something like that. But why would I stop? Recording's fun, so that's what I'm doing. Oh my god, you hear my stomach? It's terrible. Clearly I'm eating too much food too quickly, swallowing gas, and then it builds up a modern wood wall. I would love to make one of it. So yeah, I can't wait to get started on Requin and snake bird recording at some point. A short hike's... Actually, I've nearly done recording a short hike. We've nearly done everything. Like, I reached the summit. I've recorded 4 episodes, I believe. Is it right? Yeah, I've recorded 4, I think. Vivian's photo! I guess we'll hang that up as well. Officially best friends forever. So yeah, I've recorded 4 of a short hike. So that's gonna take us to like next week even. I was just having so much fun, I decided to record it instead of recording more bug fables for that day, so that's why. I've got so much on the backlog. Oh my god, my stomach! What are you doing? Please ignore all these random grumblings, it's very embarrassing. So yeah, got some more bug fables to record. It's bug fables is very much nearing the end. I've got very few things left to do. I've got like the boss trials to do, and I've got the cave of a hundred trials. And a shark. The cave of 100 trials plus the that's gonna be a suckerfish because that's not nearly big enough to be a shark. Plus the boss simulations. At least I hope that was a suckerfish. And it's wrapping up towards the end. I don't think we have much else to do on bug fables after we do those 2 things. So once we do that, then we'll be moving on to snake bird, which hopefully I can actually flex my puzzle solving skills, because that's what I'm pretty good at, puzzles. How do we only find 1 fossil? I don't know. There's apparently also some weeds over here. And I don't respect that. No weeds, this is a weed-free zone. Anyway... Yeah, I don't know where all the fossils are. Let's go hang up Vivian's photo. I can show you... whose photo was it I haven't showed you? Silvana's, I think? And then we'll round it up here and... I guess I'll go play more bug fables. We'll go do Mackie's quest thing. If you don't know anything about bug fables, this probably makes no sense to you. It wasn't Silvana. Who was it that we got one from? It was Lily! That, of course, that's right. Now we've also got Vivian's to join Lily on this wall. Cha-cha-cha. A very fancy one, Vivian. There you go. So we've got Lily and Vivian. Lily's wearing a different outfit, but Vivian's wearing her usual outfit, which I find interesting. Actually, that's the same for everyone. Why is Lily wearing a different outfit? Or is she not? And I just can't see the pineapples on it. No, that looks like a different outfit to me. I don't know. I don't know the difference. I don't know how it works. But I suppose we'll round off this episode here because that's, I mean, basically all we're doing for Animal Crossing for today, I suppose. Not much else to do. But anyway, if you have been watching, thank you very much. This has been Animal Crossing New Horizons, and I've been Dear Darling. I mean, I hope we can see each other again, but for now, it's our farewell. So until next time. Bye-bye for now.